Hi guys, and welcome back to Leslie Through the Looking Glass. For those of you that are new here, hi, my name is Leslie. For our returning viewers, as always, thank you so much for coming out and supporting my channel. It means so much to me. All right guys, happy Monday, Mental Health Monday. Life's just really up and down for me lately. Life is hard, marriage is hard, parenthood is hard. I talked about most of this stuff last week, and it's just more of the same. A little bit more like lows this week than getting through the highs like last week. But yeah. So here we are. I really work hard to try to maintain a balance and not let the swings be drastic. But that said, it doesn't always work, right? And this weekend, I don't feel like I had great balance. But, you know, I do my best. I'm just sort of in mental survival mode right now because I don't know what else I can do to improve it at this point. We have some therapy coming up next week. I'm hopeful that will help gain footing. But yeah. So that's where we're at there. But the good news is I'm still functioning through it, right? So that's the biggest thing that I learned when I was in therapy for my anxiety was just not allowing it to take over to the point where you're not functioning, because it was very easy for me to do that before. I would just shut down, and I still do that a little bit. Like, I just spent the last 45 minutes watching the Jason Kelsey retirement speech instead of doing other things I should be doing, because I just couldn't get myself to get up and move. So that's always like the balance for me and trying to figure that out. But I've learned to lean into giving myself that break when I need it in moderation, and then taking from there and doing something when I'm done. Whereas before it'd be entire days, I would just get nothing accomplished or do nothing. Anyway, sorry about that pause. But yeah, so I'm just trying to maintain that balance, and keep putting one foot in front of the next, because that's all any of us can do. But yeah, And I also have switched from, I don't always productively get done like the things on the top of my to-do list, but I go into like a spiral of getting other things done. So I still count that as a win, even if it's not like what I planned on doing. So like I was cleaning and then ended up like purging my office and the closet and all sorts of other stuff. And it's all great stuff that got done. It wasn't what my to-do list needed me to get done, but that's okay. And then I did my to-do list this morning. So, like I said, it's just about balance and finding what works. And it's an ever, like, evolving practice. But yeah. So that's that. That's kind of where we're at this week. Sorry, my eyes are so itchy. Yeah, I'm starting to yawn like I do every... I don't know what it is about sitting down to film this video makes me yawn nonstop. And then I was crying watching that retirement speech because I cry about everything. But yeah, so I don't have much. It's kind of just a standstill from last week. I feel like I had more things to talk about, but I don't really know. You know, I just have a lot of high, like, big emotion swings. Kindergarten roundups coming up next month for Amelia, and that's a lot for me because I'm not ready for it. She is. I'm not. She will be wonderful. But yeah. And then, like, exciting things that also amp up my anxiety. Like, this weekend, I got invited to Disney Princess the concert again, which I'm so excited for, and we're getting like the VIP experience, and I could not be more grateful for that. But it's also just, you know, something I'm excited for, but then also makes me feel slightly overwhelmed. And I tend to often, especially when it comes to like the social media things and like selling myself as a travel person or showcasing these events that I get to do from time to time, I often feel like I'm not like at the same level as other people, and I compare myself a lot, and the whole imposter syndrome hits me. And so I really put like a lot of pressure on myself to do a good job, and obviously I must because I keep getting to do these things, so there must be some confidence in me there on somebody's end. But I think as a smaller creator, it's very easy to look at the more established creators with the large followings and all the fancy editing and all the things, and put a lot of pressure on yourself there. So I do my best to not let that like sway me, and I get my opportunities because I just reach out and ask for them. And I am very proud of that, and I'm very, I have a great time. I do it because it's what I enjoy. It's fun experiences for me, and I love sharing them. I love that I get to take Amelia to share in these experiences or other friends, and stuff like that. But sometimes I just wonder how I'm doing it. And it gets a little like I said, it's never not fun. It's never not exciting, but it just makes me feel a little anxious. I'm so sorry, guys, I cannot stop yawning. But you know, that is just what it is. And again, I just work through it. I work on making sure I try to catch unique moments, take fun pictures, film lots of little things so I can piece together reels. Just do what is fun and putting together things that I wish I could see on other people's pages. Stuff like that. More from the aspect of joy being the focus, not the overly polished. And that's okay. And I just have to remember that. But that's really all I have today, guys. Just kind of wanted to talk about the few things weighing on my mind, and share those things because a lot of it, you know, comes back to your mental health and how you view yourself and how you embrace or fight some of these feelings. And I know not everybody does the same stuff I do on social media, so I don't know how much people relate to like that feeling, but I think in all aspects, right? Like at work, if somebody's really good at their job and you feel like they're much better than you, you might feel like you don't stack up, things like that. So imposter syndrome is a very real trick that our brain plays on us in all sorts of ways. So I just feel like it was something I don't think I've talked about a ton because for the most part, I do my best not to focus on that. But when I get bigger events or like invited to something that I didn't think I would, it just pops in my head a little bit. But that's really all I have today, guys. We're gonna sneak out and probably try to enjoy a little bit of this weather before storms come in because I think we're supposed to get more rain. But yesterday was beautiful. Saturday was beautiful. Getting some time outside was really nice. Other than can't have her windows open because that happens. She, for being a big tough Doberman, is on high alert for the tiniest of sounds. But yeah. So I hope you guys have a good week. Let's go in with a great positive attitude, and I'll see you next time. Bye, guys.